are you?
I'm good.
So I wanted to welcome you and actually have you start by telling us who you are and a little bit about the foundation that we're going to talk about today.
Sure. Well, my name's Larry Brucia, and I'm the executive director of the Joseph and Francis Brucia Foundation, which presents the Avanti Awards every year. And my sisters and I are the third generation of our family that's been supporting the arts. My grandfather in 1919 started the San Francisco Opera with the funding of the artists and the show. And in 2006, my father and mother supported the opera by doing the first simulcast.
And that's almost 100 years later.
100 years later, yeah, with my grandfather. So my sisters and I started the Avanti Awards in 2008 upon the death of my father, who wrote a poem called Avanti, which means to go forth in Italian. And he wrote it based on all the immigrants coming over to Ellis Island and how they started the opera and supported the arts. So we started the Avanti Awards in 2008, and now this coming January will be our 7th Avanti Awards.
And 7 is a big year.
It is a big year. Yes, it is.
So the Avanti Awards was named after, like you said, after the poem that your father wrote.
Yes.
And so you and your two sisters have continued a legacy. Mm-hmm. And tell me exactly what the Avanti Awards are. Obviously, it's for the arts.
Yes. So the Avanti Awards are grants, financial grants that we give to artists in the performing and visual arts.
Okay.
So it involves non-electronic instruments, photography, painting, drawing. And we have submissions every year for the Avanti Awards, and these grants are given to 3 to 4 winners every year. And the grants can be anywhere from $4,500 to $20,000.
Is there an age category?
There isn't. No, anyone that's involved in the artistic world that wants to apply can do so.
And you said non-electronic, so if I'm a photographer, would that be considered art, or is this specifically in the category of music?
In the category of music,
okay.
Pretty much non-electronic. So
okay.
Not electronic guitars, but classical guitars, violins, pianos, cellos, horns, pretty much anything that's non-electronic in the instruments. In terms of the performing arts, mm-hmm. It can be dance, it can be photography, painting, drawings, anything that is visual in its presentation.
Okay, and so tell us then what happens. So you're looking for people that are in need, right? Obviously the Avanti, you're, from what I understand, which makes this so very special,
yeah.
Is that you and your sisters have not just created a foundation to continue on with your father's legacy and the opera and being so instrumental in the arts of San Francisco, which is a wonderful thing to be able to have here in the Bay Area, so I want to thank you for that. But you are looking for something that is so unique, and that's what I appreciate about this foundation. You're looking for 3 categories of someone to apply for one of the awards. So let's talk about what those 3 qualities are.
Sure. So the 3 qualities that we look for in an application are the following. The first one is passion. How passionate are they about their art? You know, artists have tremendous amount of passion, and yet, you know, for them, it's very difficult financially to continue with that passion, especially when they're starting off and especially when they're trying to develop their art form. So we look for passion. The second thing we look for is a financial need. If there's a financial need that is there and we can help them along their way so that they can either continue their education, continue their studies, then we want to help them there.
Or even buy the instrument.
That's
that
right.
They long to play
because right. Yep.
They've been able to be influenced by someone and they just can't afford maybe to buy that piano.
We had one artist that actually bought a 8-string guitar with the Avanti Awards, and every time he looks at that guitar, he thinks of the foundation and really appreciates it. But the third criteria is basically talent. So you have passion, financial need, and talent. So it's not just talent, it's the financial need and the passion. So those are the three criteria that we review every year prior to then selecting 10 finalists. And the 10 finalists are then interviewed personally by the selection committee and additional folks that come into the selection committee based on the art form. So,
That's interesting. So if it is maybe horns, you mentioned, right, and you don't necessarily have an expert in horns on your original panel, then you would bring somebody in that could be more educated in whether
this
person is a worthy candidate?
That's correct.
Okay.
And for us, luckily, we have a wonderful relationship with the Conservatory of Music in San Francisco.
Right.
So they help us a lot with that, as well as just other folks that we know that are involved in the different arts that we can bring them in and say, what do you think? So then out of the 10 finalists, we then select the 3 to 4 winners each year.
And then tell us what happens when you have the winners. So I know that there's a couple of things with the foundation. Obviously, the money doesn't come from the sky. It doesn't just drop into your lap. Being a well-known family in the Bay Area and associated with the opera, of course, helps. But you're always looking for new people, I'm sure, to bring in. I know that many people, nowadays there's a lot of foundations, and a lot of people give money, and they're not necessarily sure where that money's going to go, whether it's for, you know, the Red Cross even. You still wonder, where is my donation going? And what's so fantastic about the Avanti Awards is that you get to actually see the person that the money's going to, and then you get to follow that person a year later. So let's talk a little bit about once somebody has decided to donate, and they know that you're going to narrow it down to those few people, how then does the donor get to know where the money's going to go?
Sure, so what makes the foundation so unique is that it's very personal. So first off, my sisters and I and all of our children are involved in the Avanti Awards. We actually talk there at the Avanti Awards and present the artists. But then the artists, if they win, they're required to come to the Avanti Awards and present or perform their art. So all the donors get to meet these young people or older people, depending upon who the winners are, and get to hear them talk, hear them perform, see what they're doing with their art, and actually get a sense of who the artists are. And then a year later, they come back and they perform and present their art again. And it's wonderful because these artists are just so appreciative, not only of the recognition of the fact that they're artists and they're struggling to pursue their passions, but they also recognize that here are people that are there supporting them, telling them, don't give up. Mm-hmm. And so it's a very personal relationship. Not only do you get to meet the artist as a donor, but you also get to experience the artist a year later and see how they've grown. And many of them have done so significantly and tell you their stories of what they're doing. So it's a very very personal experience. In fact, I guess the best way to describe it is that it's sort of like going to a very large stadium and watching a show versus being in a very intimate setting and watching the same show. It means more. It's more impactful, and it comes and makes you feel, as a donor, makes you feel like you're really making a difference. You're really helping someone out there who really cares about what you've done for them. And that is so emotional and so expressive that it's very unique, and you have to be there to really experience it, to hear those artists talk about what it means to them and to see what they're doing. And so that's what makes the Avanti Awards so different, is that it's a very personal relationship with the people you're supporting.
And it's rather immediate, the results, because while we say a year later, we all know time flies, and how wonderful to be able to see someone a year later and be directly responsible for the growth And in many times, I would imagine a total transformation to go from an art that maybe somebody's not even really aware of. I know we talked about that a little bit. You know, there could be a struggling artist out there that isn't even necessarily sure they're on the right path. And to be recognized by you and to be awarded a fund to then come back and share whatever that art is. I mean, every art that we have started off as a non-art in the beginning, and it was introduced and then carried on. So have you had any experience of somebody maybe bringing something to you that you that was a little unusual or different?
Well, actually, the very first Avanti Award winner was a young lady who was a friend of my daughter's who could sing opera, had a talent in opera. And so at my father's memorial, we had her sing Ave Maria. And it brought tears to everyone's eyes that at that point, my sisters and I all looked at each other and said, Elizabeth's going to be our first Avanti Award winner. And even though we only had one, we selected her to be the Avanti Award winner. And now today, her career is doing extremely well. She's in Europe singing with some very significant opera companies. And it's very exciting for us to watch Elizabeth. But she created that excitement. I had a young photographer who was studying, who were actually developing and producing photographs of environmental disasters. Mm-hmm. But he created such an incredible visual experience through his photographic skills that you wanted to look at these, even though they were things that you didn't want to look at.
Right. He found
the art within, and that got folks there at the Avanti Awards to actually look at what was happening. So through his talent in art, he created a visual that was completely compelling to look at. And those are the kinds of things that you really, really wouldn't discover unless the Avanti Awards found this young artist and brought him to the attention of the Avanti Awards, and his career has also blossomed into working for the Sierra Club and a lot of other organizations.
Well, I think that's what is also so neat, that it is, you mentioned personal, and it is your family and you and your sisters, because for someone, you're like a special search agent, which you know, I do for people. You're going out and you're taking the time to go through, I would imagine, a tremendous amount of resumes,
that's
and you're
correct.
Narrowing it down. So really all the donor has to do is show up to the fundraiser, meet the people, and then watch what they've personally done to help that individual. And you're almost giving it to us on a platter, saying, do you want to be part of the arts community? Do you want to make a difference in 1 to 4 people's lives?
Yeah.
Do you want to help maybe possibly transform their life and give them license to do what they want to do? And we'll do all the work for you. How many applicants do you typically get?
Well, a typical year is about 300 applications.
Wow, that's a lot.
It's a lot to go through, yes. So we spend a lot of time going through the applications, and then narrowing it down to 10 is not easy. So, but we bring in, you know, folks that we know are professional in certain areas, and we have them listen to either the CDs or the DVDs that the mm-hmm. artists send in to us, and then we choose from there. So it's a lot of work.
I would imagine that sometimes a struggling artist might be too shy to submit themselves. If someone out there knows of a deserving candidate, how would you recommend that a mother or a sister or a friend or a spouse submit their loved one without having a CD or a DVD to send you?
Sure. So the first thing they really need to do is they need to go to our website, www.avantiaward.com. And there's rules, and there's also an application. So you download the application. And then what they need to do is they need to write on the application, because it gives them a lot of opportunities to exactly tell their story. Mm-hmm. So if their child does not have a CD or a DVD or something to show, but can write a compelling story as to why we should meet this person and why we should hear what they have to say or present or sing or perform, then we will do that. So it's really about writing and telling your story about who you are and what's important to you. And so we just can't recommend enough for the applicants to really fill out that application. And, and many of them, of course, have a lot of additional pages to it, but we want them to tell us their story.
And what is the youngest applicant you've had? Not necessarily a winner, but the youngest that you can recall?
10.
Okay, and what about the oldest?
The oldest, 62.
So that's fantastic. It's like The Voice.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter how old you are. If you're talented, how young you are, it's about the passion, and it's about the need, the financial need, and then it's about the talent.
Yes, and in regards to the financial need for us, we, aside from the cost of producing the event, all the monies go to the artists. And so one of our goals is to be able to grant to the artists more dollars, because it's very expensive for artists to pursue art today, whether it's through schools or independently on their own. And so to be able to grant dollars, additional dollars to these artists, is extremely important. So one of our goals is to be able to get more people aware of what we're doing, get more funding in so that we can have more of an impact on these artists, so that they can sustain what they're doing and continue their educations even longer than what they may not be able to if they don't have the funds.
So they could use the funds to help pay their tuition?
Absolutely,
they could
yes.
use the funds to help maintain their rent so
yes.
that they could continue to pursue their dream.
That's
they could
right.
use it to pay off grants, maybe if they were lucky enough to get into a school, but now they're kind of financially stuck,
yeah.
right? What
yes.
are some other examples?
So some of the examples that the Avanti Award winners have used the monies for is obviously for tuition. Mm-hmm. Some of them have used them for special tutoring. Some of them have used them to go to school in pretty much in Europe. Many of the artists have gone musically to go to either schools in Europe or schools on the East Coast. Some of it has to buy a new guitar, as I mentioned earlier. One of it was to take the time to compose music for violin and guitar and then produce CDs so that he could then go out and present his art to folks. One of it was to go on a retreat to study the form and art under a very talented painter in terms of oil paints. So they use it in all kinds of ways, and actually one used it to help pay for their mortgage so they could continue what they're doing.
Well, everybody has their own blocks.
That's right.
And everybody's very different and individual in what it is that's blocking them. So that's
right.
what's so special about this award. Because you're allowing them to pursue it in whatever path they need to be on. But is that something that you, I guess, within having them, the artists come back a year later to present at the Avanti Award dinner, which is your gala dinner.
Yes.
There must be obviously some oversight. Let's talk about the 6 months in and,
sure.
and how you do keep track of the funds and the artists themselves.
Sure. So upon the artist receiving the award in January of each year, aside from the requirement for them to perform at that particular event, they are required 6 months later to send to us a report on how they're doing, how they're spending the money, what their studies have given to them, what art they've created, so that at 6 months we understand how they're using it and how they're progressing. So this allows us a year later to have a good sense as to what they have been doing, and then of course we talk to them again a year later, hear what they've done, and then at the dinner a year later, they present not only what they've done or performed, but they also talk to all the donors about what they've been doing.
Okay, that's really important, because then you really get to feel like you're still part of it.
That's right.
You know, and it's not a one-time dinner and then, you know what's going on.
That's right, and also each year we try to give updates to all the donors about some of the past winners. So it's exciting for them to see how these young people or older people, again, depending upon the artist, how they have evolved with their art and what they've done with it.
Yeah, like your friend that sang, you know, maybe not that 6 months later or a year later was she in Europe singing, you know, with amazing people, but maybe a few years down the line, that first year allowed her. Now, she, like you mentioned, she's in Europe and she's singing and pursuing her passion.
Exactly. And so, I mean, that's what makes the Avanti Award so wonderful, is that passionate artists don't give up. They keep trying. And if they're allowed to continue to study and work with their art based on these financial grants, then who knows what can happen with some of these artists. And, you know, in fact, one young lady won as an actress or an actor. And she went down to Hollywood and she got some roles in some pilots that are coming up.
Oh my goodness.
And she was in a movie recently. So she writes to us and says, guess what happened to me? And so it's very exciting.
Oh, wow. That's amazing. And that's a hard business to
It's a hard business.
To break into. So.
Yeah.
Well, the arts in general, I mean, I wanted to mention that's one of the most wonderful things about the Avanti Group, is that while we see the arts dwindling away in our schools and in our local communities, you're, you know, the beacon of light saying, you know, please pursue, we need artists, we need creativity, we need everything from the opera to the performing arts to move on. And while, you know, some people think, well, maybe that's not the path I should take because it doesn't seem that easy, to know that you're here in the Bay Area and you're saying, I welcome you to apply. You know, I welcome you to come as a challenge, and let's see if we can make this happen. And I think in these times for the arts, we need people like, you know, like you and the Avanti Group. It's just a wonderful thing for us to be able to have.
Absolutely. I mean, in the world that we live in today, we're bombarded with so many negative news reports of what goes on around the world, and here's an opportunity to really know that you can help young people, and again, older people, and any artists that applies, that actually wins. You can help them make a difference in the world. They can bring to the world smiles and enjoyment, and that's what art does. Art brings the pleasure of hearing wonderful music or singing, and to be able to see visual representations of the world around us in an incredible way that we normally wouldn't see. So these artists bring to us a balance to the world out there that can at times be very difficult, and it can cause us to struggle with what's going on around us, whereas these artists bring just the opposite. Mm-hmm. And so it's a very rewarding experience for donors that are participating in this.
You don't know nothing about it. Take it all.
Another thing that I want to mention is that I think it's really important that the artists understand that there is this group of donors that are looking forward to hearing from them the next year. Mm-hmm. So many of them really want to develop their art even further than what they showed the first year, so they can show the donors, look at your trust, your belief in me is actually going to result in something I'm going to show you the following year. Right. So it's a really wonderful way that it propels the artist to want to support that kind of support that they're getting from the donors.
Right, and it also, it keeps it local,
yes.
Which is fun.
Yes.
Because I know that the Bay Area has so much extraordinary talent. I was just at the symphony this last weekend,
yeah.
And it was fantastic. I mean, I've been to the symphony before, but this, for some reason, maybe it was different, but the songs were 38 to 40 minutes long.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, how do you rehearse that? How do you sit down in your living room and rehearse a 38-minute piano concerto, you know? And who sits through to say, you know, do it again? So, I mean, the amount of energy that comes from these fantastic artists, it is pure passion. I mean, the passion just drives them, because we're so used to, like, quick, immediate, you know, gratitude and yet these artists are sitting there and they're at the piano for 38 minutes at a time and they're in their own world. I mean, it was just a beautiful, beautiful thing to watch the symphony. And I thought, we live in one of the most romantic, creative, extraordinary cities in the world. And the arts are such a big part of this city. And your family is such a big part of the beginning of those arts.
Yes, and you know also what I enjoy doing is if I'm walking the streets of San Francisco or Marin County and I see an artist that's performing on the street, I'll walk up to them and I'll give them my card and I say, I want you to apply to the Avanti Awards because what you're doing here is wonderful and you need to let the rest of the world hear it. And so here's a card, here's my card, download the application and apply.
Good for you. And they're like, well, who was that man? The next thing they know, they're at the gala dinner.
Yep.
What do you think your father would say? What would his response be to your seventh year into the Avanti Awards?
Well, my father never got to experience the Avanti Awards, but I know my father would be incredibly happy. Not only the fact that his children are continuing his family's tradition of supporting the arts, but now his grandchildren are all involved. So, you know, it's the legacy that my grandfather started, that my father continued, and my mother, and the fact that children and grandchildren are continuing can only bring tremendous happiness to my father. And fortunately for my mother, who passed away this year, but she was able to experience the 6 Avanti Awards, and she was so happy that we were continuing what she and my father started.
Oh, that's wonderful. Well, I want to thank you so much for
spending
your time with us.
Well, thank you for asking me. Yeah, thank you for asking me to be here. And, you know, I look forward to anyone hearing this and seeing this to come to the Avanti Awards on January 24th.
And how do we find out about that again? You said there's a website.
There's a website, www.avantiaward.com.
And you can go there to be a sponsor and to come to the dinner, or simply maybe to even donate, even if you're an anonymous donor. Right?
That's correct, yes. And we're also on Facebook as well. So the Joseph and Francis Brucia Foundation on Facebook. And Facebook has all the artists and performances of all the artists. So it's wonderful to be able to go there and onto Facebook and see what's there.
Would you be able to find it with Avanti on Facebook?
I think they could put in Avanti, but really the website or the Facebook is primarily under the Joseph and Francis Brucia Foundation, and that's Brucia.
you anticipated my next question.
Yes,
to,
I did.
To spell that. Okay, thank you so much.
I see the crystal raindrops fall, and the beauty of it all is when the sun comes shining through to make those rainbows in my mind. When I think of you sometimes, yeah, I wanna spend some time with you, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. Just the two of us, building castles in the sky, just the two of us, you and I. We look for love, no time for tears. Wasted water's all that is, and it don't make no flowers grow. Good things might come to those who wait, but not for those who wait too late. We gotta go for all we know, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us. Just the two of us, building castles in the sky, just the two of us, you and I. I hear the crystal raindrops fall on the window down the hall, and it becomes the morning dew. Darling, when the morning comes and I see that morning sun, yeah, I wanna be the one with you, just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us.